Today's astronomers put the age of our solar system at 4.6 billion years. A span of time quite impossible for us to experience or comprehend. But here in the space theater, we can manipulate space and time. In the next 10 minutes, you will witness the chain of events that mark the evolution of our planet. But remember, we've changed the scale of time, so that what astronomers say required millions of years will take place in a few seconds. In a corner of a galaxy, a star is dying. In the death throes of gravitational collapse, there is an explosion, releasing energy in a shockwave that compresses the matter in its path. Ultimately, the wave reaches a huge nebula of dust and frozen gases. As the shock wave passes through, the cloud starts to spin and flatten. Bits of matter clump together. As they collide, some grow larger and larger by sweeping up all the material in their path. They are the nuclei of planets, comets, and asteroids. But they represent only a fraction of the matter in the original nebula. Gravity pulls most of the material to the center of the cloud. The pressure and temperature rise in the core. But before gravitational collapse can occur, thermonuclear fusion begins. A new star blazes into life. A star we have called Ra, Helios, Sol, the Sun. The new star's radiant energy is intense enough to keep the lighter compounds around the nearest planetoids from condensing. But the rocky and metallic substances solidify to form planetary cores. Third removed from the Sun, the Earth and its satellite, the Moon, begin to take shape. As the Sun stabilizes, it creates winds of energy and particles that blow away the original planetary atmospheres, leaving the inner planets exposed to asteroid bombardment from without and the deposition of molten rock from within. After a mere 300 million years, the Earth enters a new phase in its evolution. The surface begins to cool. A primordial crust forms. Heat from radioactive elements melts the rock just below the crushed surface. Volcanoes spew lava and release the gases that form the Earth's new atmosphere. One of the gases released by the volcanoes is water vapor, the remarkable combination of hydrogen and oxygen. As the water vapor rises and cools, it condenses and soon rain begins to fall. For 1 billion years, the rain falls and evaporates again, each cycle cooling the Earth's surface until liquid water accumulates in a primordial ocean. Beyond the dense clouds, the Moon goes through its own fiery evolution. Because it is smaller than Earth, it cools more rapidly, freezing the scars of an intense meteor bombardment. But on Earth, something is happening that will have a greater impact than meteors. Simple compounds and atoms are reacting to form complex organic molecules. The stage is set for the single greatest mystery in the history of the universe. By some miracle of nature, these molecules attain the ability to duplicate themselves. The genetic code is written, and life begins. Slowly but surely, organisms become more complex. Parts of the cell develop specialized functions to carry on the business of life. Another milestone is achieved as some organisms start using chlorophyll to manufacture food from water, air, and sunlight. The photosynthetic revolution begins. Blue-green algae appear and put oxygen into the atmosphere in large quantities. Oxygen that cannot exist without constant replenishing. Oxygen levels rise quickly and complex life forms appear in the ocean. Multicelled animals, worms, jellyfish. A shield of ozone formed when oxygen is ionized by the sun's energy blocks the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. No longer needing the filter that the oceans provide, life moves on to the land. But it is land that is in constant motion. Huge crustal plates are moving slowly across the face of the Earth to form a supercontinent called Pangaea. As the land changes, so does life. The world is covered in green. Flying and crawling insects appear. Then reptiles and tremendous dinosaurs. But Pangaea is unstable and fractures into a new set of continental plates. Drifting slowly after millions of years, the continents move into a pattern familiar to our eyes. The age of the giant reptiles is over, and mammals rise up to take their place as masters of the Earth. We have experienced the events of billions of years in a few brief moments. Perhaps now we can appreciate the words of Francis B. Sayer. This fragile miracle of life, spinning blue in the sea of black, precious beyond compare, sacred in its wondrous possibility.